don't just need successors. We need prophets of the living God who know their God.
Welcome, God TV viewers. I'm Joel Woodrow.
And I'm Samantha Stephen.
And we are here live in Nuremberg for the Awakening Europe conference. 70 years ago, Hitler used to parade around here proclaiming his garbage to the youth of his day. But now, 75 years later, we are proclaiming a name that is above every other name, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, is Jesus Christ. And we are sending people out from here to reclaim history,
Amen.
To get people saved, and to turn Europe back to Jesus.
And to glorify the name of Jesus. That's what the heart of everybody at this event is just to put Jesus first, to exalt his name above everything else, which is the best thing that we can do, especially when we're in this kind of environment. And the Lord is just breaking in with power. And we believe that he's going to do this across Europe. And I know that's the heart of the people here. I know Ben was talking to us yesterday about he's got a burning passion to actually go ahead and do multiple Awakening Europe events and actually see this love revolution, the love of God spread across Europe and break in. And there's nothing that can pierce the uncertainty of Europe and the, well, what we have always believed that Europe is hard, which is not the case. It's not hard to share the gospel. It's easy. With Jesus, it's easy. If we love people and we love them well, it's easy to share the message of Jesus Christ.
And that's something that Daniel Kalender, who was talking yesterday, was saying. It's like, you shouldn't be scared that it's dark, it's hard. This is what we were built for. We were made to be overcomers and we were made to shine our light. And whenever you shine light in the darkest areas, it shines the brightest. And wherever sin abounds, grace abounds much more. So in fact, this is perfect. This is perfect ground for us to be able to take back. So we shouldn't see it in a wrong way. We should actually be positive about it, which was a great word yesterday, very encouraging.
And he not only said that, he said so many people go around going, Europe is dead, the churches are dead, the young people are dead. Do you know what? As Christians, we're called to raise the dead. So let us move forward in our calling, exalt the name of Jesus, and let us go out and raise the dead. That's what we're supposed to do here. We actually want to talk to you guys a little bit about what's going on this afternoon. Who we got?
Yes, ma'am. Okay, so this morning we have the Gospel Forum Band, and then we have the pastor of that church, Peter Wentz, who's from Stuttgart. Then this afternoon we've got Chris Horschel. I hope I said your name right. He's going to be singing, sorry. And then this afternoon Ben and Todd are going to be up on stage together. They're going to be equipping everybody here to go out and evangelize and pray for the sick. And then this evening we're going to finish off with Jake Hamilton with worship, and then Heidi Baker is going to be speaking here live on God TV. It's going to be wonderful.
And we're going to be broadcasting this afternoon's equipping session on air and online. So make sure you're watching, make sure you're joining, and then go out into your neighborhood, go out into your streets and evangelize. I quickly want to talk about Peter Wentz, who's going to be on this morning, and talk about what he's doing. We've got an event called Holy Spirit Nights that we want to partner with and bring to you in October. And it's going to be amazing. Their goals are to exalt God, then that every individual in church becomes spiritually mature and learns to live as responsible and authentic Christians. The objective is also fellowship and then to be socially relevant. And that's the right order to do things. And you know what? We want to bring it to you in October, but we can't do it without you guys. We cannot do this event without you. And we need you to partner with us and join us so that we can bring you these amazing, life-changing events and see Europe saved, see the world saved, and broadcast it around the world.
Amen. Awesome. Remember, if you miss any of the sessions, please go online to www.godtv/awakeningeurope. Yesterday, there was an amazing man from Switzerland. His name is Matthias Kuhn, who was preaching. We actually have him with us here right now with his amazing interpreter. Hey, good morning. Let me give you that, Sam. Sorry. I'm going to give you the green one. Hello, my brother. How you doing?
Geht mir sehr gut. Freue mich da zu sein.
I'm fine and I'm happy to be here.
And how are you doing?
I'm fine too.
Matthias, for the people who maybe didn't see yesterday or don't know who you are, please tell the viewers at home who you are, where you're from and why you're here.
Okay. Also mein Name ist Matthias Kuhn.
My name is Matthias Kuhn.
Die meisten sagen mir Kuno.
Most people call me Kuno.
Ich habe das Privileg, seit 26 Jahren glücklich verheiratet zu sein.
I have the privilege of being happily married for 26 years now.
Und wir haben vier tolle Kinder.
And we have four great children.
Ich lebe in der Nähe von Thun, das ist in der Schweiz.
I live near Thun, that is in Switzerland.
Und durfte dort vor 15 Jahren eine Gemeinde gründen.
And I was able to plant a church there 15 years ago.
Die heißt GPMC.
It's called GPMC.
die habe ich vor einem Jahr abgegeben und leite heute das G-Movement.
I handed this church over and today I lead the G-Movement.
G-Movement, ja. Das ist eine Gemeindegründungsbewegung.
This is a church planting movement.
Mit der Sehnsucht, in ganz Europa Gemeinden zu gründen.
And it's our desire to plant churches all over Europe.
Und zusätzlich leiten wir zusammen mit einem Team das Aussendungshaus.
And on top of that, together with a team, we lead the sending house.
Dort bilden wir Gemeindegründer aus und Pioniere.
And there we actually train pioneers and church planters.
Come on, that's awesome. You're a busy man. We've got 25 nations here represented. It's 26,000 people have been in the stadium, and there's probably been more that are going to be coming. What does it mean to you that something like this is happening in Europe? What does it mean to you about awakening Europe and being here?
Für mich ist ein Traum eigentlich in Erfüllung gegangen.
For me it's actually a dream come true.
Ich glaube wirklich schon seit langem, dass Europa geweckt werden muss.
For a long time I've been believing that Europe has to be awakened.
Jesus hat gesagt, die Ersten werden die Letzten sein.
Jesus said the first shall be the last.
Die Ersten, die das Evangelium gekriegt haben, war Europa.
And the first who got the gospel were Europe.
Und wenn wir sehen, durch all die Kontinente, alle Kontinenten wurden erweckt, nur Europa nicht mehr.
Now if we look at all the continents, all of them have been revived except Europe.
Und so glaube ich, die Ersten werden die Letzten sein. Jetzt ist Europa dran, erweckt zu werden.
So I believe the first shall be the last. In that sense, now it's the time for Europe's awakening.
Und ich glaube nicht, dass Gott vor den Türen Europa steht.
And I don't believe that God stands in front of the doors of Europe.
Sondern ist in Europa.
But he is in Europe.
Und wir wollen sehen, was tut.
And we want to see what he's doing.
Und wir haben eine gewaltige Ernte vor uns.
And we have a great harvest in front of us.
Und ich bin glücklich, in dieser Zeit zu leben.
I'm totally happy to live in this time.
Yesterday you were talking about overcoming obstacles, being courageous and going for it, regardless of how hard it seems. What would you say to our viewers at home who maybe feel scared and they're fearful, they know that God has told them to go, but they don't have the courage right now, they feel alone? What would you say to encourage them?
Ich glaube, dass wir gehen, wenn wir gemeinsam gehen können.
I believe that we go when we can go jointly.
Ich erlebe es immer wieder, wenn wir zu zweit, zu dritt das Reich Gottes hinaustragen, dann werde ich mutiger.
I experience over and over, when we are two or three together, carrying out together the kingdom of God, we become more courageous.
In Lukas 10 hat Jesus die Leute zu zweit ausgesandt.
In Luke 10, Jesus sent out people two and two.
Und ich glaube, es ist so wichtig, dass wir miteinander nicht nur Seminare hören, sondern miteinander auch die Umsetzung tun.
It's so important not only to hear seminars together, but actually to implement them together.
Es ist so easy, nach einem Seminar zu sagen, wow, das war cool.
It's easy after a seminar to say, great, that was cool.
Aber es ist etwas anderes zu sagen, kommt, lasst es uns gemeinsam tun.
But it's all a different story to say, hey, let's go and do it together.
Jesus hat gesagt, die Menschen, die hören und tun, bauen auf Felsen.
Jesus said, the people who hear and do, they build on the rock.
Und da glaube ich, wir brauchen einander, um es zu tun.
And here I think we need each other in order to do it.
Und dafür brauchen wir eine jüngerschaftliche Kultur in den Gemeinden.
And for that we need a disciple-like culture in the churches.
Wo wir nicht nur das Leben miteinander und oder nicht nur die Lehre, sondern aber eben auch das Leben miteinander teilen.
Where we do not only share teaching together, but also share life together.
This is your passion. Community and discipleship. What is discipleship and what is not discipleship to you?
Jüngerschaft bedeutet genau diese zwei Worte, dass Leben und Lehre zusammenkommen.
Discipleship means that these two words come together, namely teaching and life.
Jesus hat es genauso gelebt.
That's what Jesus lived as a model.
Er hat nicht ein Event nach dem anderen gemacht.
He didn't do one event after the other.
Sondern hat 12 Leute um sich gesammelt und mit ihnen gegangen, das Leben mit ihnen geteilt.
But he gathered 12 people around him and he shared life with them.
Und das ist der Grundtyp von Jüngerschaft.
And that's the basic model of discipleship.
Paulus sagt zu den Thessalonichern,
Paul tells the Thessalonians,
ich habe mein Herz mit euch, meine Tränen mit euch geteilt.
I have shared my heart with you, my tears with you.
Jüngerschaft passiert dort, wo wir nicht nur Lehre hören, sondern miteinander die Umsetzung tun.
Discipleship happens where we do not only hear teaching together, but where we share life together.
Das ist für mich die Passion, die ich erlebe.
That is my passion.
Und Jesus hat gesagt, mache zu Jüngern.
Jesus said, make disciples.
Nicht mache zu Bekehrten.
Don't make converts.
Und das ist entscheidend.
That's decisive.
Fantastic. You two are amazing. I think you are the most passionate interpreter I've ever seen on stage. It was awesome with you guys yesterday. You are a major, major blessing. We wanted to say, God TV, we just wanted to say thank you so much for coming out here and being a part of this. You guys are awesome.
Thank you so much.
You're awesome. Okay, guys, we're going to be going to the stage real soon for the Gospel Forum Band. We just want you to know that if you want to get involved, we've got Twitter, hashtag Awakening Europe. Please let us know how this is impacting you. You can also email us live@god.tv and let us know how this is impacting you. And wherever you are in the world, contact us. We want to hear from you. From all of us here, we love you. Have a fantastic morning and we'll speak to you later. Have a great day.
God, wir sind der Tempel Gottes. And that when we look behind our lives, no matter how bad things get, we have goodness and mercy following us all the days of our life.
Und egal wie die Umstände sind, wenn wir zurückschauen, dann werden wir immer sehen, dass unser ganzes Leben lang wir von Güte und Barmherzigkeit begleitet
God,
werden.
You're a good father.
Du bist ein guter Vater, Gott.
And you have good things for your children.
Und du hast Gutes für deine Kinder vorbereitet.
And we honor you and we worship you for all the new children, the new souls that got born again last night.
Wir ehren dich und preisen dich und danken dir für alle, die neu geboren wurden und gestern zu dir gekommen sind.
We thank you, Lord Jesus.
Wir danken dir, Herr Jesus.
All of you now have thousands of new brothers and sisters.
Ihr alle habt jetzt ein paar tausend neue Brüder und Schwestern
awesome?
Bekommen. Ist das nicht
Come
gewaltig?
On, man. Come on. Well, why don't we stand to our feet? We're going to worship our King
lass
Jesus.
Lass uns aufstehen. Lass uns anbeten, König Jesus.
Why don't you guys welcome this amazing band, great friends of ours, Gospel Forum Band.
Lasst uns unsere Freunde, die gewaltige Band Gospel Forum Band, willkommen heißen.
We welcome you with praise. We welcome you with praise. Almighty God of love, be welcome in this place. We welcome you. Let your word move in power. Let what's
God is here, man.
Oh,
ist hier, Amen. Er und sein Königreich ist hier geworden.
Heute Morgen ein Bekenntnis machen, an was wir glauben, an wen wir glauben. An Jesus, Gottes Sohn.
Ich glaube an den Vater, den Schöpfer aller Welt, Gott allmächtig, durch den Geist empfangen, kam Christus in die Welt. Jesus, mein Retter. dich, Herr. Ja, ich glaube an Gott, den Vater, und an Christus, seinen Sohn, an den Heiligen Geist der Wahrheit, an den dreieinen Gott. Ja, ich glaube an die Auferstehung, das Leben nach dem Tod. Ich glaube an deinen Namen, Jesus. Hey, yeah. Oh. Mein Richter und mein Arm, gekreuzigt unter.
Den Vater Gottes, König aller Könige, wir heißen dich willkommen, wir heißen dich willkommen, wir heben deinen Namen your grace, hungry soul. über unser Land, dein Name Jesus. Über diesen Kontinent, dein Name Jesus.
Your will be done. Peace. lift up your spirit this morning. New sound of worship. Release them in the cities and the countries and the continent of Europe. A new sound of worship. New sound of worship. Release them from your spirit. New sound of worship. New sound of worship. With everything, we will shout for your glory. With everything.
We live shine. Keep singing. Let's keep worshiping.
Singt weiter, macht weiter. Come on, lift up your worship.
Set your affection on him.
Setz deine Aufmerksamkeit auf ihn.
Put your heart on your king.
Richte dein Herz auf den König.
Jesus.
Proklamiert über deinem Land, wo immer du herkommst. Herr, sei du erhöht über
Just
meine Nation.
Right now. If you're at home, declare it.
Bete in deiner eigenen Sprache, auch ihr zu Hause. Betet in euren eigenen Sprachen.
Just lift up the nations.
Erhebt die Nationen.
If anybody in this stadium can, grab a hand, the person next to you.
Wenn es möglich ist, dann ergreif die Hand der Person neben dir.
Let's declare together.
Und lasst uns zusammen verkünden.
With one voice.
Mit einer Stimme.
Europe will be saved. You ready?
Europa wird errettet. Seid ihr bereit?
On the count of three.
Auf drei.
And when you do this, man, it's not just something we shout, it's not hype.
Das ist nicht nur so ein Hype, dass wir hier irgendwas rumschreien.
This is a declaration to the principalities and powers about who really is king.
Das ist eine Proklamation der Gemächte und der Gewalten, dass sie wissen, wer wirklich König ist.
Ein, zwei, drei. Europe will be saved! Wer von euch stimmt dem zu? We have something very special that's about to happen.
Wir haben hier etwas ganz Besonderes vor.
I personally believe that what's happening today here this morning.
Und ich glaube auch, dass persönlich das, was hier heute Morgen passiert,
is going to release something in the heavens and on the earth. That's going to change the history and face of Europe.
Wird etwas im Himmel und auf Erden freisetzen, was die Geschichte Europas und hier verändert.
Today we'll have the honor.
Heute haben wir die Ehre,
but honoring the King of Heaven and also the fathers and mothers of Europe who went before us.
Den König des Himmels zu ehren und auch die Väter und Mütter, die vor uns hergegangen sind.
And so I'm going to invite them up in just a moment, but first of all, why don't you thank the band?
Ich möchte sie gleich
what
nach vorne
an amazing
bitten.
Job they did.
Aber lass uns der Band Danke sagen für den tollen Lobpreis.
Oh man, I don't know about you, but we always just want to keep worshiping, man. That's all we want to do.
Ich weiß nicht, wie es euch geht, aber wir könnten die ganze Zeit so weitermachen.
Everyone here, we're just ruined to praise God.
Wir wollen einfach nur Gott preisen.
Oh, it's incredible.
Es ist unglaublich.
Have a seat.
Bitte nehmt Platz.
We wouldn't tell you to calm down. That would be absolutely impossible in this stadium.
Wir werden euch nicht bitten, dass ihr euch beruhigt, denn das ist in dem Stadion ja fast unmöglich.
Does anyone else feel a little bit like their heart is burning with absolute fire?
Wer spürt, dass ein Feuer im Herzen brennt?
Awesome. God is here, man.
Gott ist hier.
Todd and I, we have the honor and privilege this morning of actually sharing with you guys our heart about why we did this event a little bit and taking up the offering this morning.
Todd und ich haben heute Morgen das Vorrecht und die Ehre, euch ein bisschen von unserem Herzen von dieser Veranstaltung nochmal zu erzählen und auch das Opfer einzusammeln.
So, we made the executive decision as a team.
So, wir haben als Team beschlossen,
long time ago,
vor langer Zeit,
to make this whole event 10 euros.
Dass wir 10 Euro nur für die Eintrittskarten verlangen wollen.
I remember when I told people,
man, this is so cool here. I just listened to the music and the worship today. Just a couple of things that just came to my mind. You know, the Bible says that the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. That means that every inch of this planet belongs to Jesus. And he said, I'll give the nations to you if you ask me for it. We also know that God says that gifts are temporal, but there's three things that are eternal: love, faith, and hope. We always focus on love, but hope, the confident expectation of good. God looks at this planet with so much hope. And we need to look at Europe with hope, knowing that this place is definitely going to turn. So as we were just singing that song about hope, let hope arise. I just pray for all of us today that we would just allow that gift, that spiritual, eternal gift inside of us to rise up, and that we would look at this planet, we would look at Europe, and we would say, this place can definitely change. Absolutely. I'm not going to listen to everybody else. I really believe the Lord in heaven that this place can change. So I just was thinking about that as we were worshiping.
But that's why it's so important. If you're at home, don't spectate. Make sure you're participating, because when people are on stage and they're saying join hands in your home. Because when we all shout together as the body of Christ, Europe will be saved. Something breaks in the spirit and something shifts. And when you join at home, what we're blessed to do through television is invite you to participate with us. We can actually connect the body of Christ, brothers and sisters around the world, to join in corporate prayer like we've never seen on such a scale. So when you intercede from that position in your heart, that we're glorifying the name of Jesus together as the body of Christ around the world. Right now they're just taking the offering, and I just want to let you guys know, look, to bring this event to you, it costs us 80,000 euros. And you know, we're coming up next week, we've got our family broadcast there. And if it's on your heart, if the Lord puts it on your heart, would you consider giving to us? Would you consider supporting God TV? We have so many things we want to do. We were telling you earlier about the Holy Spirit Nights, which we're so excited about, going on in Stuttgart. We can't bring this stuff to you without your support. We've got Soul Survivor coming up. We couldn't do Soul Survivor last year, but this year, because of your faithful giving, we're able to bring it to you again. The Lord is moving in power, and the Holy Spirit is moving across the face of the earth and changing things. And we want to partner with God to make that available around the world to people who may not be able to travel, who may not be able to leave, to close nations where you may legitimately not be able to get out of your country to come and join. We have the privilege and the honor of carrying the presence of Jesus and what he's doing here to you in your homes. So we just want to encourage you, if you are in a closed nation, let us know. We're praying for you. Our hearts are for you. Our hearts are for all of our brothers and sisters around the world. We just want to lift you up and pray for you and bless you. And that's our heart. Our heart is to see the church equipped to reach the lost around the world. And we cannot do that without your support. Your support enables us to change lives. And it also enables us to change your lives and bring you and into his presence and into what God is doing. To hear what the Spirit is saying and see what the Lord is doing today on the earth.
Amen.
What's the whole point that we do this? Last night was the whole point of why we do what we do at God TV. There was thousands of people came down from every part of the stage down here and responding to what Todd was talking about. This love, this person, this God man, this Jewish man that was on the earth 2,000 years ago that came down here and said, I want to know you. I want a relationship with you. Will you let me love you? And people came down from all over, and that's what it was all about. We really, really want you to know that's the heart of God TV. We have someone who's just an amazing man. He's from Bethel. He's here. He's going to be speaking tomorrow. His name is Paul, and he's actually joined us right now. And we're just going to pull you in, my friend. Hello, my friend. How are you doing?
I'm very good, thanks. Amazing.
Yeah. I'm going to just stick this. Oh, sorry
great
about that.
Honour to be here and be with you.
Paul, for people around the world that maybe don't know who you are, just tell us a little bit about yourself and how you met Jesus.
Well, I'm Paul Mamoring, and I'm on the senior leadership team at Bethel Church. I've been there since 2001. I'm a Brit, proud to be a Brit, proud to be a European. I gave my life to the Lord on February the 28th, 1973, by my father's dead body, which is very significant for me here today. And I've worked as a nurse. I worked 19 years in the prison service of England, and I was a prison governor in England, and then went out to Bethel, Reading in 2001. I describe myself as the most surprised man I know that I get to do what I get to do. I lead our network, Global Legacy. I teach and preach in our school. But 3 years ago, I got given a prophetic word that I would do stadiums, and I can't believe that this is now my journey. So, yeah, that's me, and I really am amazed that I'm here.
You said that it's very significant that you're here. And you mentioned your father. You want to tell us what you mean by that?
Well, 70 years ago, our fathers and our grandfathers were fighting. And 70 years ago, my father was walking and driving around the streets of Germany. He was seconded by the British government as part of the intelligence team to come and clear out the bomb-making equipment of Germany. Prior to that, he'd been on the design team of Barnes Wallace's bouncing bomb, famous for the dam busters, but a tragedy here. We were dropping bombs on each other 70 years ago. We were fighting. But today, we're here. Under the name of one father, we're dropping some different bombs. They're bombs of love, they're bombs of joy, they're bombs of salvation. And for me, being here is redemption. This is what it's all about. I'm a European and I love this country. And to be here, I can feel my dad in my ear as everything I do, that we're redeeming something that was tried to be destroyed 70 years ago. So it means a lot.
We were just talking as a crew yesterday, and actually one of our crew members was saying, you know, I really feel like whenever Germans hear about the Second World War, there's shame that comes on them, and they feel so down about what happened. What would you say to them? How can we deal with that shame? How can they deal with that shame?
That's a great question. Tomorrow afternoon I'm preaching on Luke 15, and in Luke 15, the father ran. Not many people know why the father ran, but it's believed that because of the culture of the day, that the villagers would have come out with a large clay pot and greeted the young boy when he came home and smashed that clay pot. It's called the Kazazar ceremony. You can read about it in Kenneth Bailey's book on the Middle East. The point of that is they would shame the boy out of the village. And here's the incredible truth. The father bore our shame on the cross of Jesus Christ. He bore our sorrows and our shame. And I believe right here in Germany, shame is being ended today. 70 years is not a generation, it's a lifetime. And it's time to start a new lifetime. And so the Father bore our shame. And tomorrow afternoon, I will have every German in this stadio stand up and say, He bore your shame. But not only does He bore our shame, the kingdom payback for shame is a double portion, a double anointing. And that's the kingdom value on this. It's the kingdom payback for shame. It's the kingdom economy. You get a double portion instead of shame. How do we deal with it? By standing up, by acknowledging it, by being authentic. Because in the garden, the Father, God, was looking for Adam. Where are you, Adam? You see, being authentic destroys shame. And the payback, a double portion. I believe that this is the beginning of a new lifetime. 70 years later, it's not another generation. We're done with repentance. We're done with saying sorry. It's time, as it says at the end of Luke 15, to start to live again.
Paul, if there's someone at home or a group of people at home that maybe are German, maybe they're not, but they're dealing with shame, can you pray for them right now?
Sure. I would invite you to do this. Stand up where you are. because standing up is an acknowledgement and saying, in response to the Father, here I am. Because the Father's saying, who told you you were naked? Who lied to you? Who told you you're walking in shame? Shame is anything that tells you what you're not, and it will keep you from the one voice that alone can tell you who you are. And shame will keep you in hiding. And the Father's saying, where are you? Stand up. Who told you you were naked? And as you stand right now, I declare you don't need inner healing for this. Just standing up destroys it. It deals with it once and for all. It deals with shame. And being authentic, that gown of shame drops to the floor, and you stand before the Father completely clean, completely restored. And I pray for you right now that you will feel that and you will know it, and that what's more, right now you would receive the double portion which will benefit your wife, your husband, your children, and your relationship with the Father. Your shame, as the song says, is undone right now. No more shame. Receive the double portion in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Paul, can Europe be saved?
Absolutely, no doubt about it. This, turn to the back of your Bible, find the maps, and there's a map. It's the Roman Empire, typically, that's colored in. It goes from Ireland to Israel and beyond. It is the birthplace of civilization, the cradle of civilization. But what's more, it is the birthplace of Christianity. And anywhere else in the world that has had a revival had one, because Europe had one first, and we sent it to the world. And so it's right that it comes back to Europe, and Europe will be saved. Europe will walk in revival once again, because it is our birthright, it is our inheritance, and the Father is speaking loud and clear right now that Europe will be saved.
Come on, who said the English were dignified? You're on fire, Paul.
Yeah, I left that dignity a long time ago with a prophetic word that I would raise up young evangelists and preach in stadiums.
Just last question. What does it feel like, the people at home who are not here, what does it feel like for you to see all of these people here from all over Germany, all over Europe, worshipping?
You know, there's a song right now, it's I'm in over my head. I'm in over my head and I'm completely at home. It's overwhelming, but it's okay. It's like overwhelming in the greatest possible way. This is a crowd almost out of control. This is a worship conference almost out of control. The job description I got last night, end worship, it's impossible. You can't close worship here. Worship is just becoming a part of everyone's life in this stadium, and it is absolutely amazing, breathtaking. And thanks for tuning in and experiencing a little, and we'll try and release as much of it as we possibly can to you.
Paul, we love you. Thank you so much for joining us. I know you're busy, and we're going to be looking forward to hearing you tomorrow. You enjoy your day today, sir.
I will. Thank you very much for having me. It's been an honor.
You're a good man.
Thanks. Bye.
Bless you, buddy.
Bye.
Come on, Sam. Come join me.
We're back. That was amazing.
It's pretty cool, isn't it?
I love the hat. It just stirs up a fire and a sense of passion. Yeah, I do have my microphone in hand. My producer's telling me, lift your microphone to your mouth. Right now, we're having a beatbox session. I mean, how amazing is God that he would bring what many people would consider foolish? And I know I spoke to you guys at home about this before. Don't look at this and go, oh, what are they doing? Why are they doing this? Beatboxing? Why would they just stand and worship? You know what? The Father, he loves everyone.
Yeah.
And we're made in his image. And our diversity reflects him. Our talents and the gifts that he's given us reflect him, his glory. Our God is fun.
We serve
a God of liberty. Where the Spirit is, there is freedom. And you know what? There is freedom all over the place here. God is moving.
You know this is biblical, don't you?
Tell me.
We come from a new priestly order. We're not of the order of the Levites anymore. We're order of the Melchizedek.
Oh, no. That was punny. I liked it.
So Jesus can beatbox. Well, he created everything, so I'm sure when we get to heaven, he'll be like, you think you can beatbox? Check this out.
But you know what? The thing with Jesus is that he did things which the Pharisees... No, sure. The Pharisees and the Sadducees, when they saw it, they were going, that's not what we know. That can't be God. Who are you? And he turned to them and he said, you whitewash sepulchres. How dare you? He was enraged because he was glorifying the Father. And when you glorify the Father and you glorify the Father and you worship him in spirit and in truth, you bring honor to his name.
That's what the Bible says. Whatever you do, do it to glorify the Lord.
Amen.
At home, remember, you can contact us. We want to find out how you're doing, how this is touching you, how it's impacting you, where you are in the world.
And we're going to let you know exactly how to do that in just a moment. But we've got some people that have been doing some feedback. Just want to read this out to you. Hello, friends. My husband and I are watching from Romania. We wanted to be in Nuremberg now, but we're waiting on a German visa for my husband from Nigeria. On Tuesday, we have to leave the country, so please join us in prayer that we will receive a call from the embassy today. We will be able to come to the conference for Sunday. Lots of love and greetings from Romania.
Let's pray for them.
Yeah, absolutely. You want to do that?
God, I ask that you would give Isaac and Caroline favor that they would join us tomorrow when we bless them.
Open doors in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, Papa. We've got some other ones here. I'm watching from Kenya, East Africa. Indeed, it's a blessing to listen to gospel music from Nuremberg, Germany. And that's, we haven't got a name for that, but whoever you are, love you loads. Praise the Lord, I'm watching God TV from Hamburg. Would love to join you there, perhaps the next one. And apparently there are going to be more, so yes. Perhaps you guys have the name of the bands, the one from now who was playing today. Would love to get some material, like CDs. God bless you. Yep.
We've got more. It says, hi, God TV, watching God TV from Kochi, Kerala, in South India. God TV has become my life and thrilled to see the human race united. Hold in one loud shout for our God, El Shaddai.
Amen. Just to let you know, we have Jesus Culture and the God Encounter Band. All right, we've got Pete Events coming up. He's going to be on stage, and he's going to be preaching. So we're going back to him right now. Enjoy this.
Fetten Applaus heute Morgen. Ihr Lieben, hier in diesen Tagen geht ein Traum in Erfüllung.
Friends, a dream is coming true these days.
Etwas, auf was wir lange, lange gewartet haben.
Something we've been waiting for a long time.
Und man kann mit Worten gar nicht beschreiben, was man empfindet.
You can't even explain in words what we're feeling.
Wenn du es dann mit deinen eigenen Augen siehst.
When we see it with our own eyes.
Wir werden gleich hier einen prophetischen Akt vollziehen.
We're going to do a prophetic act here very soon.
Etwas, was Gott, unser Vater, uns aufs Herz gelegt hat für diesen Morgen.
Something God the Father put on our heart for this morning.
Und das wird etwas Powerfules sein.
It's going to be something powerful.
Und nicht nur für uns hier im Stadion, sondern für alle, die jetzt am Livestream zugeschaltet sind.
Not just for us here in the stadium, but for everyone who's watching via Livestream.
Und wir glauben, dass der Segen über ganz Europa fließen wird.
And we believe that this blessing will spread throughout Europe.
Weil es Gott versprochen hat in seinem Wort.
Because God promised it in his word.
Und was Gott zusagt, das hält er auch gewiss.
And what God promises, he keeps.
Gestern Abend ist hier an diesem Ort etwas Historisches passiert.
Something historical happened here yesterday evening.
Und ich bin so froh, dass ich Zeuge sein konnte davon.
And I'm so glad I could be a witness of it.
Ich habe gesehen, dass in einer einzigen Versammlung hier in Deutschland
I saw that in one single meeting here in Germany
so viele tausende Menschen ihr Leben Gott geweiht haben.
So many thousands of people dedicated their lives to Jesus.
Sich zu Jesus bekehrt haben.
They turned to Jesus.
Von neuem geboren worden sind.
They were born again.
Erfüllt mit der Kraft des Heiligen Geistes.
And filled with the power of the Holy Spirit.
Wie noch nie in einer einzigen Versammlung in der neueren Zeit hier in Deutschland, von der ich weiß.
That's never happened recently in a meeting here in Germany, as far as I know.
Ihr Lieben, das ist etwas Historisches.
That's something historical, people.
Es ist eine neue Zeit.
It's a new time.
Und niemand wird aufhalten, was Jesus vorhat zu tun.
And nobody can stop what Jesus is planning to do.
Und du und ich, wir sind zusammen dabei.
And you and I are a part of it.
Und Gott wird dich und mich dazu benutzen.
And God will use you and me for this.
Dass in unseren Ländern das passiert, was der Vater im Himmel auf dem Herzen hat.
That in our countries, the things the Father has planned will happen.
Weil er hat uns ausgestattet mit der Kraft seines Heiligen Geistes.
Because he has equipped us with the power of his Holy Spirit.
Ich möchte euch gern etwas erzählen, was mir die letzten Tage passiert ist.
I'd like to tell you something that happened the last days.
Und es hat mit ganz Europa zu tun.
It has to do with all of Europe.
Ich war vor ein paar Tagen noch in Frankreich.
A couple days ago I was in France.
Gestern waren wir noch in einem Tal in der Schweiz.
And yesterday I was in a valley in Switzerland.
Ah! Heute sind wir hier in Deutschland.
And today we're here in Germany.
Ah! Und ganz Europa ist per Internet zugeschaltet hier.
And all of Europe is here via Internet.
Und wo immer du hingekommen bist in diesen Tagen.
And wherever you've been the last days.
Das waren keine kleinen, harmlosen Versammlungen.
It wasn't just small meetings, harmless meetings.
Sondern überall hat Gott seine Leute zusammengebracht.
Everywhere God was pulling his people together.
Überall sind große Wunder passiert.
Everywhere there were big miracles.
In Frankreich, im Norden, haben wir erlebt, wie eine Frau, die 8 Jahre total verkrüppelt war.
In France we experienced how a woman who had been crippled for 8 years.
Ihre Knochen waren zerschmettert durch einen Autounfall.
Her bones were smashed through a car accident.
Wie Jesus sie berührt hat und sie vor allen Leuten auf und ab gehen konnte ohne irgendwelche Schmerzen.
How Jesus touched her and she was able to walk in front of all these people with no pain.
In der Schweiz waren 1500 Leute zusammen aus allen Denominationen und Konfessionen.
In Switzerland we had 1500 people together from all denominations.
Und alle zusammen ein Herz und eine Seele.
And we were all one heart and one soul.
Und jetzt kommt man hier nach Nürnberg.
And now here we are in Nürnberg.
Und wir spüren etwas, dass ein neuer Tag angebrochen ist.
And we sense that a new day has come.
Und dass Gott etwas Neues tut in unseren Ländern.
And that God is doing a new thing in our countries.
Ich möchte gerne jetzt etwas tun.
I would like to do something now.
Wir werden in wenigen Minuten Väter aus den verschiedenen Nationen, geistliche Väter, willkommen heißen.
In a few minutes we will welcome spiritual fathers from the nations.
Und wir wollen einen prophetischen Akt heute Morgen hier vollziehen.
And we want to do a prophetic act here this morning.
Wir wollen die Nationen Europas segnen.
We want to bless the nations of Europe.
Mit großer Vollmacht und geistlicher Autorität.
With great power and spiritual authority.
Und wir wollen besonders auch die neue und die nächste Generation segnen.
And we want to bless especially the new, the next generation.
Und bevor wir das tun, möchte ich uns etwas aus der Heiligen Schrift vorlesen heute Morgen.
Before we do that, I want to read you something from the Holy Scriptures.
Etwas, was uns zeigt, was hier gleich passieren wird.
Something that will show us what will be happening here.
Damit wir ein Verständnis von dem haben, was Gott der Vater im Himmel geplant hat.
So that we understand what God the Father has planned.
In Hebräerbrief Kapitel 11.
Hebrews chapter 11.
Vers 20 lesen wir Folgendes.
Verse 20 we read the following.
Durch den Glauben.
Through faith.
Segnete Isaak seine Söhne Jakob und Esau.
Isaac blessed his sons Jacob and Esau.
Und zwar tat er das im Hinblick auf die zukünftigen Dinge, die geschehen sollen.
And he did it viewing the things that would happen in the future.
Und dann im nächsten Vers,
the next verse,
Vers 21,
verse 21,
lesen wir Folgendes.
We read,
und Jakob,
and Jacob,
der von seinem Vater Isaak gesegnet worden war,
who had been blessed by his father Isaac,
der tat genau das Gleiche.
He did exactly the same thing.
Die Bibel sagt uns, er segnete jeden der Söhne Josefs.
The Bible tells us he blessed the sons of Joseph.
Jeden einzelnen.
Every single one.
Und er sagt, ich werde hier nicht von dieser Erde gehen.
He said, I will not leave this earth.
Bevor nicht jeder aus der nächsten Generation die Fülle des Segens des Himmels abbekommen hat.
Until the next generation has received the fullness of the blessings of heaven.
Und hier sehen wir ein Prinzip der Heiligen Schrift.
And here we see a principle of the Holy Scriptures.
Hier ist die Generation von Vätern.
Here we have the generation of the fathers.
Isaak oder Jakob.
Isaac or Jacob.
Und sie erkennen ihre Verantwortung vor Gott.
And they recognize their responsibility before God.
Sie haben geistliche Autorität.
They have spiritual authority.
Sie haben ein besonderes Mandat von Gott.
They have a mandate from God.
Damals hießen sie die Patriarchen.
We called them the patriarchs.
Und sie sagen, das, was Gott uns geschenkt hat,
and they said, what God has given us,
das soll in allen kommenden Generationen freigesetzt sein,
shall be set free throughout the next generation
und sich multiplizieren.
And multiply.
Es soll noch stärker werden.
It should get even stronger.
Und heute Morgen,
and this morning,
sind wir alle zusammen hier,
we're all here together,
weil wir etwas möchten,
Because we want something.
Wir wollen, dass in allen Ländern Europas,
we want all countries of Europe,
alle Generationen,
all generations,
alle Sprachen,
all languages,
alle Kulturen,
all cultures,
alle, die von irgendwoher auch aus anderen Nationen hierher gekommen sind,
everyone who's also come from other nations,
dass sie alle mit der Kraft des Heiligen Geistes berührt werden,
that they would all to be touched with the power of the Holy
Spirit, und die Herrlichkeit des Vaters erleben,
and experience the glory of the Father.
Wer das glaubt, sagt Amen.
Whoever believes that says Amen.
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 Und niemand auf der ganzen Welt wird das aufhalten können.
And no one on this earth will be able to stop it.
Wir glauben, dass durch diesen Segen ganze Ortschaften, Dörfer und Städte berührt werden.
We believe that entire nations, cities and villages will be touched through this.
Und damit du eine Vorstellung hast, wie das aussieht, möchte ich dir gerne etwas erzählen, was vor kurzem passiert ist.
And so that you can have a picture of what this can look like, I'd like to tell you something that happened recently.
Ich war mit meinem Freund Jean-Luc in der Schweiz.
I was in Switzerland with my friend Jean-Luc.
In einem Tal.
In a valley.
Und wir hatten keinen geistlichen Dienst.
And we had no spiritual ministry.
Wir hatten eine schöne, gute, freie Zeit zusammen.
We just had a nice leisure time together.
Und wir waren in einem schönen Restaurant.
And we were at a nice restaurant.
Wo ganz viele Weinproben stattfinden.
Where you could sample wine.
Und das ist ganz bekannt in dieser Gegend.
It's very well known in this area.
Die Leute kommen von überall her dorthin.
People come from all over.
Und wir hatten eine herrliche Zeit, 2 Stunden, 3 Stunden dort.
And we had a great time together, 2 hours, 3 hours.
Mit unseren Familien zusammen.
Together with our families.
Und plötzlich, während wir dabei waren, aufzubrechen,
and when we were getting ready to leave,
kommt eine Frau.
A woman came.
Und sie sagte, ich kenne sie.
And she said, I know you.
Ich habe gehört, dass sie für kranke Menschen beten.
I've heard that you pray for sick people.
Dann hat sie gesagt, dass sie ein schweres Unglück erlebt hat.
She told me she had had a bad tragedy happen.
Sie war irgendwo in einen Brand reingekommen.
She had been involved in a fire.
In ein schlimmes Feuer.
A very bad fire.
Und dann hat sie eine Rauchvergiftung bekommen.
And she had been poisoned by the smoke.
Und dieser Rauch hatte ihr die ganze Lunge verätzt.
And the smoke had burned her lungs.
Und sie war vollkommen arbeitsunfähig und schwach.
And so she was unable to work and she was weak.
Und wie sich herausstellte, war diese Frau die Mitbesitzerin dieses Restaurants.
And it turns out this woman was also a partial owner of this restaurant.
Und sie war bekannt im ganzen Ort, in der ganzen Gegend. Jeder kennt diese Familie.
And everybody knew this woman and this family in the region.
Mit ihren Brüdern und Schwestern leitet sie den Betrieb schon seit Jahrzehnten.
She's been running this restaurant for decades with her family.
Da hat sie uns gebeten, kommt ihr mit hoch in mein Wohnzimmer.
So she asked us to join her in her living room upstairs.
Da sind wir mitgegangen, hinten irgendwelche Stiegen hoch, in einen kleinen Raum oben unter dem Dach.
So we went up some narrow staircases to a small apartment under the roof.
Dann hat sie uns ihre Bilder gezeigt und ihre Familiengeschichte erzählt.
She showed us pictures and told us her family history.
Und wir haben gesagt, oh, wir müssen jetzt aber wirklich gehen.
And we said, oh, we really gotta go now.
Und dann hat sie uns das noch erzählt und das noch erzählt.
And then she told us this and that.
Wir haben gesagt, wir müssen wirklich gehen. Unsere Frau, unsere Kinder warten auf uns.
And we said, we really gotta go. Our families are waiting for us.
Schließlich konnten wir für sie beten.
So finally we could pray for her.
Und in dem Moment, wo wir ihr die Hände aufgelegt haben,
and at the moment we put our hands on
kam
her,
die Kraft Gottes so stark auf sie, dass sie nicht mehr stehen konnte.
The power of God came on her so mightily she couldn't stand anymore.
Und Gott sei Dank stand hinter ihr ein Sofa.
And thank God there was a couch behind her.
Und sie lag da auf dem Sofa und schnaufte von ganzem Herzen.
And so she lay down on this couch and just breathed deeply from her whole heart.
Und sie schnaufte und zitterte, weil die Hand des Allerhöchsten Gottes auf ihr war.
And she was breathing and shaking because the hand of God was on her.
Der Segen unseres Vaters im Himmel.
The blessing of our Father in heaven.
Und als sie aufstand, sagte sie, ich bin total geheilt.
And when she got up, she said, I am completely healed.
Ich kann wieder atmen.
I can breathe.
Meine Lunge funktioniert wieder.
My lungs are working again.
Und sie hat geschnauft.
And she panted and breathed.
Und was dann passiert ist, habe ich noch nie erlebt.
And I've never experienced what happened next.
Sie ging mit uns wieder diese Stiegen runter.
She went down the staircase with us again.
Und unten war alles voller Menschen.
And down below in the restaurant, everything was full of people.
Die haben Wein gekauft.
They were buying wine.
Und die kamen aus dem Restaurant.
Coming out of the restaurant.
Alles war voll.
It was all full.
Und sie ging gleich zu den Leuten hin und sagt, ich bin geheilt, ich bin geheilt.
She went up to the people and said, I've been healed, I've
ich kann
been
wieder
healed.
Richtig atmen.
I can breathe again.
Und innerhalb von Minuten
and within minutes,
hat der halbe Ort mitbekommen, was Jesus getan hat.
Half the town knew what Jesus had done.
Und ich möchte uns etwas sagen. Inzwischen sind die Dokumente vom Arzt gekommen.
And I'd like to tell you something. In the meantime, we've gotten documentation from the
doctor. Er hat diese Heilung total bestätigt.
He confirmed the healing completely.
Schwarz auf weiß.
Black on white.
Und diese Frau.
And this woman.
Die den Segen des Himmels bekommen hat.
Who received the blessing from heaven.
Sie sorgt dafür, dass der Ort hört, wer Jesus Christus ist.
She's making sure the town hears who Jesus Christ is.
Wir werden gleich etwas tun.
We're going to do something in a moment.
Wir werden mit wunderbaren Männern und Frauen Gottes die Nationen Europas segnen.
We're going to bless the nations of Europe with wonderful men and women.
Die nächste Generation, Gott weiß.
We'll dedicate the next generation to God.
Proklamationen sprechen über unseren Ländern.
And speak out proclamations over our countries.
Und wenn wir das tun, so wie es Isaac und wie es Jakob getan hat.
And if we do it the way Isaac and Jacob did.
So wie es Jesus getan hat über seinen Leuten.
The way Jesus did it over his people.
So wie es der Vater mit seinem Sohn Jesus tat.
And the way the Father did it to his son Jesus.
Und sagt, das ist mein geliebter Sohn.
And he said, this is my beloved son.
Auf ihn hör.
Listen to him.
Und er ihn vor allen segnete.
And he blessed him in front of everybody.
Und sich zu ihm stellte.
And he stood to him, beside him.
So werden wir genauso heute Morgen im Namen Jesu Christi.
We, in the same way, in the name of Jesus.
Euch alle hier, aber auch die anderen Nationen segnen.
We'll bless everyone here, but also the other nations.
Wir werden die guten Worte Gottes über seinem Volk und über den Nationen aussprechen.
We will speak the good words of God over his people and over the nations.
Und das Wort Gottes wird das bewirken, wozu es heute ausgesandt wird.
And the word of God will do whatever it has been sent out to do this morning.
Und niemand auf der ganzen Welt wird das verhindern können.
And nobody on this earth can stop it.
Niemand auf der ganzen Welt.
No one on earth.
Einige der Väter und der Mütter aus unseren verschiedenen Ländern hier in Europa sind hier.
Several of the mothers and fathers of the nations are here.
Hier auf der Plattform.
Here on the platform.
Hier im Stadion sind ganz viele wunderbare Männer und Frauen Gottes.
And here in the stadium are many wonderful men and women of
God. Väter und Mütter in Christus.
Fathers and mothers in Christ.
In den verschiedenen Ländern gibt es tausende wunderbarer Väter und Mütter, die heute nicht hier sein können.
And in the nations there are thousands of mothers and fathers who can't be here today.
Aber was wir tun werden,
but what we want to do,
wir werden stellvertreten für viele andere.
We will do it representatively for many others.
Den Segen aussprechen über ihn.
And speak out blessing.
Und darf ich uns alle einladen?
Can I invite you?
Die Väter und Mütter, die heute hier sein können.
The fathers and mothers who can be here today.
Und sich bereit erklärt haben, den Segen Gottes auszusprechen über uns.
And have agreed to speak out God's blessing
over us. Dass wir sie ganz herzlich willkommen heißen.
Please welcome them.
Hier im Grundig-Stadion in Nürnberg.
Here in the Grundig-Stadion.
Herzlich willkommen. Ihr Lieben, können wir alle zusammen aufstehen?
Could you please stand up?
Und Vater im Himmel,
Father in heaven,
wir bitten dich jetzt im Namen Jesus,
we ask you in the name of Jesus,
dass durch die Kraft des Heiligen Geistes,
that through the power of the Holy Spirit,
durch die Inspiration des Himmels,
through the inspiration of heaven,
Durch das Wirken deiner Kraft und Stärke.
Through the working of your power and strength.
Die Worte der Gnade und des Segens über unsere Nationen ergehen.
That the blessing of your power and word will come over the nations.
Sei willkommen, Heiliger Geist.
We welcome you, Holy Spirit.
Sei willkommen, du Geist der Prophetie.
We welcome you, Spirit of Prophecy.
Dass wir über die Zukunft reden unserer Nationen.
That we can speak about the future of our nations.
Das, was du uns eingibst.
What you want to say.
In dem Namen Jesu Christi.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Halleluja. Danke, Jesus, für deine Gegenwart.
Thank you, Jesus, for your presence.
Danke für diesen historischen Moment.
Thank you for this historic day.
Dass du neu wieder deinen Fuß auf Europa setzt.
That you set your feet on Europe again.
Und dass du deine Liebe und deine Kraft ausbreitest über jede Nation.
And that you extend your love and your power to all the nations.
Und so segne ich die Nationen in Europa.
So I bless the European nations.
Im Osten, im Westen, im Norden und im Süden.
The East, the West, the North and the South.
Ich segne besonders die junge Generation und die nachfolgende Generation.
I bless especially the young and the next generation.
Im Namen des Vaters und des Sohnes und des Heiligen Geistes.
In the name of the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit.
In der Kraft Gottes aufzustehen.
To rise up in the power of God.
Mit Zeichen und Wundern das Reich Gottes zu verkündigen. Und zu demonstrieren.
To demonstrate and proclaim the kingdom of God in signs
Heiliger
and wonders.
Heiliger Geist, sei willkommen auf diesen Generationen.
Holy Spirit, be welcome on the next generation.
Und ich setze frei Apostel, Propheten, Hirten, Lehrer und Evangelisten.
And I receive the apostles, prophets, pastors,
und ich rufe aus über Europa.
And I declare over Europe.
Dein Reich komme.
Your kingdom come.
Dein Wille geschehe.
Your will be done.
Wie im Himmel,
in heaven,
so in Europa.
So here in Europe.
In Jesu Namen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Wir rufen aus über Deutschland heute.
And we proclaim over Germany today.
Ein neuer Tag ist angebrochen.
A new day has come.
Wir stehen auf.
We stand up.
Denn unser Licht ist schon gekommen.
Because our light has already
die
come.
Die Herrlichkeit des Herrn geht auf über uns.
The glory of the Lord is rising upon us.
Der Himmel ist offen.
Heaven is open.
Wir warten nicht auf Erweckung.
We are not waiting for revival.
Wir empfangen Erweckung.
We receive revival.
Der Heilige Geist wird ausgegossen.
The Holy Spirit is being poured out.
Es ist schon angebrochen.
It has already started.
Wir rufen aus über Europa.
We declare over Europe.
Der Krieg ist vorbei.
War is over.
Wir sind vereinigt.
We are one.
Nicht die Euro.
Not around the Euro.
Sondern Jesus Christus.
But around Jesus Christ.
Der König.
The King.
Alle Nationen.
Of all the nations.
We declare that Jesus Christ is the rock on which the church is built.
Wir deklarieren, dass Jesus Christus der Felsen ist, auf dem die Kirche gebaut ist.
We decree that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God.
Wir deklarieren, dass Jesus der lebendige Sohn des lebendigen Gottes ist.
And he is building his church in Europe.
Und baut seine Gemeinde in Europa.
And the gates of hell shall not prevail.
Und die Tore der Hölle sollen es nicht überwinden.
We decree a marching army in Europe.
Wir sprechen eine marschierende Armee in Europa.
With a banner in their hand.
Mit der Flagge in der Hand.
That Jesus Christ is Lord.
Dass Jesus Christus der Herr ist.
And we open the gates.
Und wir öffnen die Tore.
For another way.
Für einen weiteren Weg. Für den Weg der Herrlichkeit. Für einen Weg für übernatürliche Evangelisation. Wir deklarieren über jede Nation Europas. Gott wird aufstehen. Sein Volk wird aufstehen. Die Generationen werden miteinander gehen und demonstrieren das Herz des Vaters, die Segnungen des Vaters. Und ich segne die nächste Generation mit dem Sohn im Herzen.
And with a light in your eyes.
Und mit dem Licht in den Augen.
And with power.
Und mit Kraft.
And endurance.
Und Aushalten.
And abundant grace.
Und überfließender Gnade.
And love.
Und Liebe.
And that you run your race.
Und dass du dein Rennen läufst.
With your eyes on Jesus.
Mit deinen Augen auf Jesus.
And I decree, run your race.
Und ich deklariere, lauf dein Rennen.
To win Europe.
Um Europa zu gewinnen.
To win Europe.
Um Europa zu gewinnen.
For the Lamb of God.
Fürs Land Gottes.
To stand on this land as a Brit is such an honor.
Hier auf diesem Land zu stehen ist so
eine Ehre. I declare that we are united under one Father.
Ich deklariere, dass wir unter einem Vater vereint sind.
And He is bigger than everything that has ever divided us.
Und ist größer als alles, was uns zuvor getrennt hat.
I bless you as sons and daughters.
Ich segne euch als Söhne und Töchter.
I bless you as mothers and fathers.
Ich segne euch als Väter und Mütter.
Get on our shoulders.
Kommt auf unsere Schultern.
Stand taller.
Steht, werdet höher.
Run faster.
Lauf schneller.
Go higher.
Geh höher.
Take the land.
Nimm das Land.
Moses blessed the people.
Moses hat das Volk gesegnet.
He said, take the land that I will never see.
Hat gesagt, nimm das Land ein, das ich niemals sehen werde.
Our fathers and our grandfathers cheer us on.
Unsere Väter und Großväter feuern uns
From
an.
The great cloud of witnesses.
Von der großen Wolke der Zeugen.
I bless you as a father.
Ich segne euch als Vater.
Go further.
Geh weiter.
In every sphere.
In jeder Sphäre.
In every career.
In jeder Karriere.
Erase the secular sacred line.
Geh über die säkulare Linie hinaus.
Be united.
Seid vereint.
Under one Father.
Unter einem Vater.
Under one Lord Jesus.
Unter einem Herrn Jesus.
With the Holy Spirit.
Gefüllt sei mit dem
Hold
Heiligen Geist.
Nothing back.
Halte nichts zurück.
Lay down your lives.
Leg dein Leben nieder.
Climb on our shoulders.
Klettere auf unsere Schultern.
And we will serve you for the rest of our days.
Und wir werden dir dienen für den Rest unseres Lebens.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, because this is the time for Europa.
Danke, Herr, denn das ist die Zeit für Europa.
This is God's time for Europa.
Das ist Gottes Zeit für Europa.
And this is harvest time for Europa.
Und das ist Erntezeit für Europa.
And thank you, Lord.
Und danke, Herr,
for the millions of European souls.
Für die Millionen von europäischen Seelen.
Standing to the valley of the decision.
Die da stehen in dem Tal der Entscheidung.
Ready to say yes for Jesus.
Bereit, um ja zu sagen für Jesus.
That's for now. I bless you in the name of Jesus.
Und so segne ich euch im Namen von Jesus.
I bless you to bring the gospel of the living God.
Ich segne euch, um das Evangelium des lebendigen Gottes zu bringen.
I bless your life, your family, your ministry and your church.
Ich segne dein Leben, deine Familie, deinen Dienst und deine Kirche.
To bring the gospel with a demonstration of power.
Um das Evangelium in der Demonstration der Kraft zu bringen.
Be blessed in the name of Jesus.
Sei gesegnet im Namen Jesus.
And now in the name of Jesus.
Und jetzt im Namen von
as
Jesus.
The Holy Spirit is overing this place.
So wie der Heilige Geist an diesem Ort ist.
As the Holy Spirit is overing Europe.
So wie der Heilige Geist über Europa ist.
I release the gifts of healings to your life.
Ich setze die Gabe der Heilung.
I release the gift of performing miracle.
Ich setze die Gabe, um Wunder zu tun, frei.
I release the gift of faith.
Ich setze Glauben frei.
And I release the fire of the Holy Spirit.
Und ich setze das Feuer des Heiligen Geistes frei.
Receive this fire in the name of Jesus.
Empfange das Feuer des Heiligen Geistes.
To preach the gospel.
Um zu gehen und das Evangelium zu
predigen.
In jede Stadt in Europa.
Every village.
In jedes Dorf.
The fire of the Holy Ghost.
Das Feuer des Heiligen Geistes.
In the name of Jesus.
Im Namen von Jesus.
Et maintenant je termine et je bénis la Suisse romande. Je bénis les Suisses romands, je bénis la France, je bénis la principauté de Monaco et je bénis la Belgique au nom de Jésus-Christ. Amen.
Amen. und ich spreche aus über Europa.
Over every business person.
Über jeden Geschäftsmann.
New revelation.
Neue Beziehungen.
New resources.
Neue Ressourcen.
New ideas.
Neue Ideen.
New engineering.
Neue
engineering.
Ja, neue.
New ideas to break through.
Neue Ideen, um durchzubrechen.
I declare over the money of Europe.
Ich spreche aus über dem Geld von Europa.
That money is not ruling Europe.
Dass das Geld nicht Europa regiert.
But Jesus Christ is ruling Europe.
Aber Jesus Christus regiert Europa.
Money, you are not the king of this continent.
Geld, du bist nicht der König dieses Kontinents.
We serve the lords of the lords.
Wir dienen dem Herrn der Herren.
We serve the one who has endless resources.
Wir dienen dem, der endlose Ressourcen hat.
And none of our nation is gonna lack money.
Und keines unserer Nationen wird Mangel haben an Geld.
Because the money is for serving God.
Denn das Geld ist dazu da, um Gott zu dienen.
And our nation are gonna serve God.
Und unsere Nationen werden Gott dienen.
Our governments are gonna serve God.
Und unsere Regierungen werden Gott dienen.
Our business are gonna serve God.
Unsere Geschäfte werden Gott dienen.
Big businesses.
Große Geschäfte.
Small businesses.
Kleine Geschäfte.
Every one of them.
Jede einzelne davon.
Are joining to bring the gospel in Europe.
Halten zusammen, um das Evangelium in Europa zu bringen.
Europe shall no more lack money.
Europa soll keinen Mangel mehr haben an Geld.
Nobody in Europe, on every joint nation.
Keiner in Europa, in jeder zusammengefassten Nation.
We lack money.
Soll Mangel an Geld haben.
I declare it in Jesus' name.
Das spreche ich aus im Namen von Jesus.
And I bless each one of you.
Und ich segne jeden einzelnen von euch.
Who are in government.
Ob in der Regierung.
And I pray that Joseph wisdom will be upon you.
Und ich bete, dass die Weisheit von Joseph auf dir ist.
I release Joseph wisdom to rule this country and this continent.
Ich setze die Weisheit von Joseph frei, um dieses Land und dann diesen Kontinent zu regieren.
And I bless every owners of business.
Und ich segne jeden Geschäftsinhaber.
And I bless you with the capacity to bring forth wealth.
Und ich segne dich mit der Kapazität, Wohlstand hervorzubringen.
I bless your family.
Ich segne deine Familie.
I bless your heart.
Ich segne dein Herz.
And I pray that the power of God stay and rest upon you.
Und ich bete, dass die Kraft Gottes auf dir ist und auf dir bleibt.
Amen.
Amen.
Wir proklamieren über Europa.
Proclaim over Europe.
Vom Norden bis zum Süden.
From the north to the south.
Vom Westen bis zum Osten.
From the west to the east.
Dieses Wort aus Psalm 24.
The word in Psalm 24.
Hebt euch aus den Angeln, ihr Tore.
Open wide your gates.
Öffnet euch weit, ihr alten Portale.
Open wide up your ancient doors.
Denn der König will einziehen, die höchste Majestät.
Because the King of Glory, the highest majesty, wants to come through you.
Und wir proklamieren, dieser König ist Jesus Christus, der Auferstandene.
We proclaim this King is Jesus Christ, the risen one.
Er ist unser König.
He is our King.
Und er ist der König von Europa.
And he is the King of Europe.
Und wir proklamieren, dass du, Jesus, die Herzen der Väter zu den Söhnen wenden wirst.
And we proclaim, Lord, that you will turn the hearts of the fathers back to the sons.
Damit wir gemeinsam in die Ernte vorangehen können.
So that we can go together into the harvest.
Und wir proklamieren, dass die Ernte nicht beginnen wird.
And we proclaim that the harvest is not yet to come.
Sondern dass die Ernte begonnen hat.
But that the harvest has already started.
Und wir freuen uns auf Tausende von Menschen, die zu Jesus kommen.
And we are excited about thousands of people that will come to Jesus.
Und es ist Zeit, dass Europa zu Jünger von Jesus werden.
And it's time that Europe becomes disciples of Jesus.
Im Namen Jesu.
In Jesus' name.
Padre. Grazie.
Danke.
Che davanti ai nostri occhi, Signore.
Dass vor unseren Augen, Herr,
c'è l'adempimento, il compimento. È completo, è compiuto.
Es ist vollkommen, es ist vollbracht.
Quello per cui abbiamo pregato.
Für das wir gebetet haben.
Abbiamo digiunato.
Wir haben gefastet.
Abbiamo sperato.
Wir haben uns hingegeben.
Abbiamo combattuto.
Wir haben gekämpft.
Ma oggi, Padre.
Aber heute, Vater.
Grazie.
Danke, Vater.
Perché questo grande raccolto.
Weil diese große Ernte.
È iniziato.
Hat begonnen.
E noi profetizziamo.
Und wir prophezeien.
Su questa generazione, Padre.
Über diese Generation, Vater.
Spirito Santo.
Es ist der Heilige Geist.
Dal Nord.
Vom Norden.
Dal Sud.
Im Süden.
Dall'Est.
Im Osten.
Dall'Ovest.
Im Westen.
Soffia su questa generazione.
Über diese Generation.
La potenza del tuo spirito, Signore.
Die Kraft deines Geistes,
risusciti questa nazione.
Erwecke diese Nation.
Risusciti questo continente.
Bring es in diesen ganzen Kontinent.
Signore, che segni e prodigi.
Herr, wir sprechen es aus.
Possano essere fatti.
Dass es getan ist.
E che il nome di Gesù Cristo.
Und dass im Namen Jesu Christus.
Può essere innalzato.
Dass erhoben ist.
E il cuore ferito.
In dem Herzen.
Di questa Europa.
Von diesem ganzen Europa.
Può essere sanato.
Dass es gesund wird.
Perché l'Europa sarà salvata.
Denn Europa soll errettet werden.
Europe will be saved.
Europa wird errettet.
Europe will be saved.
Europa wird errettet.
Europe will be saved.
Europa wird errettet. Halleluja.
Eine Zeit der Einheit.
Father, this is the time of unity.
Wo jung und alt zusammenstehen.
Where old and young stand together.
Alle Generationen.
All the generations.
Alle Kinder.
All the children.
Alle Jugendlichen.
All the youth.
Alle Väter und Mütter.
All mothers and fathers.
Alle Omis und Opis.
All grannies and granddaddies.
Wir stehen zusammen.
We stand together.
Unsere Generationen sind nicht geteilt.
Our generations are not divided.
Gemeinsam bauen wir das Reich Gottes.
And together we're building the kingdom of God.
Und wir erobern unser Land.
And we take back our land.
Mit deiner Liebe.
With your love.
Mit deiner Größe.
With your greatness.
Du hast Zukunft und Hoffnung für uns.
You have a hope and a future for us.
Du hast uns unsere Nationen gegeben.
You have given us our nations.
Und in unserer Zeit.
And in our time.
In unserer Generation.
In our generation.
Wollen wir sehen, dass die Menschen dich lieben.
We want to see that the people love you.
Dass sie dich kennenlernen.
That they get to know you.
Und dazu stehen wir gemeinsam.
And for this we stand together.
Jung und alt.
Young and old.
Arm und reich.
Poor and rich.
Groß und klein.
Tall and small.
Wir haben die Zeit der Einheit.
We have the time of unity.
Wir stehen zusammen.
We stand together.
Wir verbünden uns.
We unite ourselves.
Für Einheimische und Ausländer.
For those who are living here and for people from other countries.
Viele Nationen in Europa.
Many nations in Europe.
Arbeiten zusammen für dein Königreich.
Working together for your kingdom.
Danke, dass du uns zusammenbringst.
Thank you for bringing us together.
Über alle Grenzen hinweg.
Beyond all boundaries.
Und dass du Mauern einreißt.
That you tear down walls.
Und unsere Herzen verbindest.
And connect our hearts.
Zu deiner Ehre.
For your glory.
Zu deiner Herrlichkeit.
And for your honor.
Weil du gesagt hast.
Because you said.
Nehmt einander an.
Receive one another.
Wie ich euch angenommen habe.
Just as I received you.
Zum Lob Gottes.
For the praise of God.
Amen.
Amen.
Vor drei Wochen habe ich in der Tageszeitung die Presse in Österreich gelesen.
3 weeks ago I read the newspapers in Austria.
Und wenn man Jesus nicht kennt,
and when you don't know Jesus,
kann das eine depressive Sache sein.
Then you can get very depressed.
Und ich habe den Herrn gefragt, was hier geschehen wird.
And I asked the Lord, what is going to happen here?
Und Gott sagte,
and God said,
der Löwe aus dem Stamme Juda wird brüllen.
The lion of the tribe of Judah will roar.
Und wenn ich Zweifel gehabt hätte daran,
and if I had doubt about this,
dann erinnere ich mich heute noch an gestern Abend.
Then I would look back to last night.
wie hungrige 2000 Leute, 3000 Leute da hier runtergelaufen sind.
How 2,000-3,000 hungry people were running down the track.
Nicht lang überlegend, ob Jesus gut ist oder nicht.
Not contemplating in their mind if Jesus is God or not.
Aus dem innersten Herzen heraus in der Not zu Jesus zu kommen.
But out of their need, from the deepest heart, they came to Jesus.
Ihm näher zu kommen.
To draw nearer to him.
Und das macht mir solchen Mut.
And this encourages me so much.
Ich habe vor 15 Jahren eine Prophetie bekommen.
15 years ago I received a prophetic word.
Dass ich wie Simeon da hier stehen würde.
That I will be like Simeon standing here.
Genauso wie er das Baby Jesus in den Armen gehabt hat.
Like he had the baby child in his arms.
Würde Jesus. Ich Erweckung in meinen Armen haben.
The baby Jesus. So I would have a revival as a baby in my arms.
Und meine Lieben, das hat nichts mit mir zu tun.
And beloved, this has nothing to do with me.
Aber das bricht momentan an.
But this is what's happening right
now. Was wir uns so gewünscht haben.
What we've been looking for.
Vater, ich bitte für diese Generationen.
Father, I pray for these generations.
Dass unsere Augen auf Jesus gerichtet sind.
That our eyes will be fixed on Jesus.
Bring uns eine Tunnelvision bei.
Give us a tunnel vision.
Dass wir nicht abgelenkt werden von den Dingen, von den guten Dingen und von den schlechten Dingen.
So that we won't be distracted by both the good and the bad things.
Sondern unsere Augen auf Jesus gerichtet haben.
But that our eyes are only focused on Jesus.
Als den einzigen, den wir ehren und lieben wollen.
As the only one that we want to honor and love.
Amen.
Amen.
Wolfgang and my father fought against one another in the Second World War.
Wolfgang und mein Vater haben im Zweiten Weltkrieg gegeneinander gekämpft. Wolfgangs Vater und mein.
And we stand here for reconciliation.
Und wir stehen heute hier für Versöhnung.
Wolfgang's father died at a very young age in the war.
Wolfgangs Vater starb in noch sehr jungen Alter im Krieg.
Many of you are his age.
Viele von euch sind in seinem Alter.
And you have the job to bring life to people of your age and older.
Und du hast den Auftrag, Leben zu bringen in deine Generation und in die deines Alters.
So first of all, I want to pray reconciliation over you.
Zuerst will ich Versöhnung über dir aussprechen und beten.
I pray reconciliation within families.
Ich spreche Versöhnung aus über Familien.
I pray reconciliation amongst the nations.
Ich bete für Versöhnung unter den Nationen.
And most of all, I pray reconciliation with your and my God.
Und am meisten bete ich für Versöhnung zwischen dir und deinem Gott.
I want to pray for a second thing.
Für eine zweite Sache möchte ich beten.
I want to pray for the love of God.
Ich möchte beten für die Liebe Gottes.
As a mother and a grandma, I want to pray the love of God upon you.
Als Mama und Oma möchte ich die Liebe Gottes über dir beten.
My generation have prayed for you since before many of you were born.
Meine Generation hat für dich gebetet, bevor viele von euch überhaupt geboren waren.
I pray, Father God, that that love of yours would flow through this generation to the next generation and to the next generation until Jesus comes again.
Und Vater Gott, ich bete, dass deine Liebe von einer Generation zur nächsten Generation, weiterfließt, bis Jesus wiederkommt.
And I pray that this wonderful gift that God has given you.
Und ich bete, dass dieses wunderbare Geschenk, das Gott dir gegeben hat,
which is life,
welches Leben ist,
and life in abundance,
und Leben im Überfluss,
that you don't keep it for yourself, but you pass it on.
Dass du es nicht für dich behältst, sondern dass du es weitergibst.
Thank you, Jesus.
Danke, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Father, we approach you.
Vater, wir kommen zu dir.
In the name of your Son.
Im Namen deines Sohnes.
Our Redeemer and Intercessor.
Unser Erlöser und unser Fürbitter.
And our Father, I pray.
Und Vater, ich bete,
that you'll release the spirit of sonship.
Dass du den Geist der Sohnschaft freisetzt.
To the fatherless societies of Europe.
Zur vaterlosen Gesellschaft in Europa.
Spirit of sonship.
Geist der Sohnschaft.
Rest on every individual here.
Ruhe auf jeden einzelnen hier.
Remove the orphan spirit.
Nimm diesen weisen Geist weg.
And bring the new identity of sons and daughters of the King.
Und bring die neue Identität als Söhne und Töchter des Königs.
Father Almighty.
Vater Mächtiger.
Rest in the power of your spirit on every individual.
Ruhe in der Kraft deines Geistes auf jeden Einzelnen.
But give them also the authority of your name, Jesus Christ.
Und gib ihnen auch die Autorität in deinem Namen, Jesus Christus.
That every one of them will be shifting the spiritual atmosphere of towns, villages and regions.
Dass jeder Einzelne die Atmosphäre im Geist in Dörfern und Städten verändert.
But give them also wisdom.
Und gib ihnen auch deine Weisheit
and discernment
und deine Unterscheidung
and tender spirit
und einen sanften Geist
to recognize your desires
um deine Wünsche zu erkennen
for their life calling and assignment here on earth
für ihre Lebensbestimmung hier auf Erden
that everything that you deposited for them in heaven
dass alles was du für sie im Himmel vorbereitet hast
through the spirit of wisdom and revelation
durch den Geist der Weisheit und Offenbarung
obedience and courage
Gehorsam und Mut
will be fulfilled here on earth
wird hier auf Erden vollfüllt werden
give them wisdom
gib ihnen Weisheit
to establish strong marriages
um starke Ehen zu führen
strengthen their families
stärke ihre Familien
strengthen their churches
stärke ihre Kirchen
because it's time to stand up
denn es ist Zeit aufzustehen
and shine with your glory
und mit deiner Herrlichkeit zu scheinen
Father we release the next generation following us
Vater lass die nächste Generation uns
let them
folgen.
Go Let them go further and higher.
Lass sie weiter und höher gehen.
More powerful and more authority.
Kräftiger und mit mehr Vollmacht.
Let them take Europe for your glory.
Dass sie Europa für deine Herrlichkeit einnehmen.
Amen.
Amen.
Our heavenly Father.
Unser himmlischer Vater.
We thank you for this day of miracles.
Wir danken dir für diesen Tag von Wunder.
This is the new day for Europe.
Das ist ein neuer Tag für Europa.
And thank you that we can proclaim your holy name.
Und danke, dass wir deinen heiligen Namen aussprechen können.
The name of Jesus Christ.
Den Namen von Jesus Christus.
And thank you, Holy Spirit, for your presence here now.
Und danke, Heiliger Geist, für deine Gegenwart hier und jetzt.
That we can proclaim words now.
Dass wir diese Worte proklamieren können.
To this new generation, be blessed.
Für diese neue Generation sei gesegnet.
And you are blessed to be the blessing.
Und du bist gesegnet, um der Segen zu sein.
And wherever you go to your nations.
Und wo immer du hingehst in deine Nation.
You take the blessing from heaven.
Du bringst den Segen des Himmels.
And you speak the words of life.
Und du sprichst die Worte des Lebens.
You speak the words of forgiveness.
Du sprichst die Worte der Vergebung.
You speak the words of reconciliation.
Du sprichst die Worte der Versöhnung.
But you will do this in love of Jesus.
Und dass du das tun kannst in der Liebe von Jesus.
In this love of Jesus there is healing.
In dieser Liebe von Jesus ist die Heilung.
There is healing for broken hearts.
Da ist die Heilung für gebrochene Herzen.
There is healing for broken families.
Dort ist die Heilung für zerbrochene Familien.
And Lord is sending you now from this place.
Und der Herr sendet dich jetzt aus diesem Ort.
To carry his love.
Um seine Liebe zu tragen.
And this love will change the whole nations.
Und diese Liebe wird die ganzen Nationen verändern.
It will be for his glory.
Es wird für seine Herrlichkeit sein.
But also for the blessing of people.
Aber auch für den Segen der Menschen.
And we just say what's the
decided in heaven.
Und wir sagen, was im Himmel entschieden ist.
It just happened here on earth.
Geschieht jetzt hier auf Erden.
In the power of Jesus.
In der Kraft von Jesus.
But in his power of love.
Das in der Kraft seiner Liebe.
When you make the decision, you will know, because you will know it from the Lord.
Wenn du Entscheidungen triffst, wirst du es wissen, denn du wirst es vom Herrn empfangen.
And be brave and bold.
Und sei mutig und kühn.
Be courageous to show his love.
Sei mutig, seine Liebe zu zeigen.
There is a great joy in heaven.
Da gibt es eine große Freude im Himmel.
And may this joy now is ignited in your heart. It's the joy of the Lord is your strength.
Und möge diese Freude in deinem Herzen entzündet sein, denn die Freude am Herrn ist deine Stärke. Amen.
Ich sah eben ein Bild über Europa. Und ich konnte an meinem Körper fühlen, wie Gott es bestätigen wird.
And I could feel in my body that God would confirm it.
Während die Gebete des Segens und die Proklamationen gesprochen wurden.
While these prayers of blessings and proclamations were spoken.
Vielleicht konnten einige das ausspüren, dann kam hier ein Wind in das Stadion rein.
Maybe some of you could feel it too. A wind came into the stadium.
Ein mächtiger Wind, und er ging über ganz Europa.
A mighty wind, and it blew over
in jedes
all of
Land.
Into every country.
Und ich konnte spüren, wie die Menschen auf ihrer Haut, in ihrem Herzen, den Wind spüren konnten dort.
And I could sense how people could feel this wind on their bodies and their hearts.
Es war fühlbar.
It was tangible.
Es war mächtig.
It was mighty.
Und wir wollen jetzt etwas tun, alle zusammen.
And we want to do something all together now.
Zehntausende zusammen.
Tens of thousands together.
Auch am Livestream.
Also in Livestream.
Wir wollen zusammen die Worte des Segens aus dem Vater Unser singen.
We want to sing the words from the Lord's Prayer.
Wir singen es zusammen auf Englisch.
We'll sing them together in English.
Yours the kingdom.
Yours is the kingdom.
Yours the glory. Yours the power. Forever.
Yours is the glory. Kingdom, yours is the power, yours is the glory forever. Amen. Yours is the kingdom, yours is the power, yours is the glory forever. Amen. Yours is the kingdom, yours. It's the power, yours is the glory.
Nehmt noch mal Platz, wir haben was ganz Wichtiges vor.
Please sit down, we have something very important planned.
Ich möchte zwei Männer auf die Bühne bitten.
I'd like to invite two men on the stage.
Die wie vielleicht keine andere diese nächste junge Generation repräsentieren.
That represent this new generation perhaps as no one else can.
Und wir wollen sie segnen und stellvertretend für sie die nächste junge wilde Generation.
And we want to bless them and with them all the generation, the next wild young generation.
Herzlich willkommen, Ben und Todd. Would you come, please? Peter. This is diese junge Generation.
This young generation
hat keine Angst.
Is not afraid.
Aber sie hat Jesus in ihrem Herzen.
They have Jesus in their hearts.
Und wir wollen sie segnen. Wir wollen Ben und Todd segnen.
We want to bless them. We want to bless Ben.
Und ich möchte dich bitten, streck deine Arme aus.
We'd like to ask you to stretch out your hands.
Wenn wir sie segnen und stellvertretend mit ihnen.
And we want to bless them and with them everyone.
Die nächste Welle.
The next wave.
Von Evangelisten.
Of evangelists.
Und von Männern und Frauen Gottes.
And of men and women
in unseren
God,
Nationen.
In our nations.
Und in Europa.
In Europe.
Und weit darüber hinaus, dass sie das Reich Gottes bauen mit Kühnheit und mutig, ohne Furcht und mit reinem Herzen und mit ihrem Blick ausgerichtet auf Jesus. Und wir segnen euch. Wir segnen euch, dass alles, was ihr aufgetragen bekommt, von unserem Herrn, dass ihr alles durchführen könnt. Ihr werdet alles haben, was ihr braucht. Vor euch werden die Türen aufgehen. Und ihr werdet eure Generation zu Jesus führen. Und wir werden gemeinsam, jung und alt, erleben, wie Millionen zu Jesus finden. Und wir senden euch. Und wir segnen euch.
And we bless you.
Und wir stehen mit euch.
And we stand with you.
Seite an Seite.
Side by side.
Und ihr dürft verrückt sein.
You can be crazy.
Ihr dürft Dinge tun, die wir nie getan haben.
You may do things that we never
ihr könnt Dinge
do.
Tun, wovon wir geträumt haben.
You can do things that we've only dreamed of.
Und wir sind dabei.
And we'll be with you.
Und wir danken, dass wir Hand in Hand gehen.
And we thank you that we can go hand in
thank
hand.
You, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And we bless you.
Wir segnen euch.
We bless you.
Wir segnen euch.
On this very day,
an diesem Tag,
with a special blessing of protection around yourself,
mit einem besonderen Segen des Schutzes euch herum,
I declare in the authority of the name of Jesus Christ
und ich proklamiere in der Autorität
that
von Jesus
no
Christus,
weapon formed against you shall prosper.
Dass keine Waffe gegen euch
gerichtet. We bless your bodies with health.
Wir segnen euren Körper mit Gesundheit.
Divine health.
Göttlicher Gesundheit.
Divine godly holy strength.
Göttlicher Kraft, heiliger Kraft.
The hand of God Almighty be with you and your families.
Die Hand des allmächtigen Gottes sei mit euch und euren Familien.
Everything the Father has on his heart for you.
Alles was der Vater auf seinem Herzen hat.
Shall come to pass.
Soll stattfinden.
Thank Father for
for servants.
Wir danken dir, Vater, für Diener.
For the spirit of humility.
Für den Geist der Demut.
And we bless you that you are examples for many of thousands of young people and elderly people.
Und wir segnen euch, dass ihr Beispiele seid für tausende junge Leute und
in
ältere
Jesus
Leute.
Mighty name.
In Jesu mächtigem Namen.
The mighty hand of God shall be with you.
Die mächtige Hand Gottes soll mit euch sein.
Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
Halleluja. Und das ist nicht nur Europa.
It's not just Europe.
It's not only Europe.
Es ist nicht nur Europa.
This is a time for the nations.
Es ist eine Zeit für die Nationen.
And the Lord has given you many nations.
Und der Herr hat euch viele Nationen gegeben.
And many continents.
Und viele Kontinente.
And I bless you with open doors.
Und ich segne euch mit offenen Türen.
All over the world.
Überall auf der Welt.
You haven't seen yet, nothing yet.
Ihr habt bis jetzt noch nichts gesehen.
And I bless you with the power of the Holy Ghost.
Ich segne euch mit der Kraft des Heiligen
Geistes. I bless you with boldness.
Ich segne euch mit Kühnheit.
I bless you with power and signs and wonder.
Ich segne euch mit Kraft und Zeichen und Wunder.
It's a double portion.
Es ist eine doppelte Segnung.
And it's an anointing of breakthrough into nations.
Es ist eine Salbung des Durchbruchs in die Nationen.
So don't be afraid.
Habt keine Angst.
Take the nations.
Nehmt die Nationen.
Take
ein.
The world for Jesus.
Nehmt die Welt ein für Jesus.
Ich möchte uns alle bitten heute an diesem Tag.
I'd like to ask all of us today.
Auch alle, die am Livestream zugeschaltet sind.
Also all the ones watching via Livestream.
Bitten um euer Gebet.
I would like to ask you for prayer.
Für alle, die auch vorne an vorderster Front oft stehen.
For those who are standing at the front lines.
Sie brauchen besonderen Schutz.
They need special protection.
Und dein Gebet ist so powerful.
And your prayer is so powerful.
Es ist so stark.
It's so strong.
Weil es setzt die Kraft von Gott frei.
Because it sets the power of God free.
Danke dafür.
Thank you.
Nicht nur heute, sondern alle Tage deines Lebens.
Not just today, but all the days of your life.
Deine Gebete sind so wichtig.
Your prayers are so important.
God bless.
Come and sit down. Come and sit.
Bitte kommt und setzt euch mal hier hin.
Come and sit. On both sides of these.
Bitte setzt euch
lights.
Hier an der Seite hin.
Just here. These men and these women went before us.
Diese Männer und Frauen sind vor uns hergegangen.
God chose people over his house in these nations, and these are the people responsible for this actually.
Das sind die Verantwortlichen, die Gott sich auserwählt hat für diese Sache, für
because
sein
they,
Haus.
They fought and they prayed for years that God would bring people together to take back Europe, to bring it to Jesus.
Die haben jahrelang dafür gekämpft und gebetet, dass Gott die Menschen zusammenführt und die Leute wieder zurück zu Jesus bringt.
And we have to honor them.
Und wir müssen sie auch ehren.
So just please pray with us. This is a holy moment.
Es ist ein heiliger Moment, bitte betet mit uns.
We have to honor these men and women.
Wir müssen diese Männer und Frauen ehren.
Let's stand, let's pray for them.
Lasst uns zusammen aufstehen für sie beten.
That God would do more in their latter years than he did in the beginning.
Dass Gott in ihren späteren Jahren noch mehr tut, als er in den Jahren bisher gemacht hat.
The generation that seeks the face of God, the Jacob generation.
Und dass sie eine Generation sind, die das Angesicht Gottes sehen, die Jakobs Generation.
We honor you guys, man. I'm trembling. We're wrecked by what God has already done through you all.
Wir sind so, so voll und ganz erfüllt von dem, was ihr und durch euch was Gott getan hat. Wir wollen euch die Füße waschen.
We love you. We're gonna take off your shoes.
Wir lieben
bless
euch.
You.
Wir werden euch die Schuhe abziehen und euch segnen.
allmächtig Zeit im Glauben aufzustehen, voller Vertrauen auf dich. Meine Augen werden Wunder sehen, durch den der Allmächtig ist. Du bist der Hörer des Gebets, ich komm zu dir. Der Hörer des Gebets, dein Geist ist hier, um zu tun, was deinem Herzen entspricht. Es ist die Zeit, im Glauben aufzustehen, voller Vertrauen. Durch den der Allmächtig ist. Du bist der Hörer des Gebets. Ich komm zu dir. Nur ein Wort in deiner Vollmacht und es geschieht. Du bist der Hörer des Gebets. Dein Geist ist hier, um zu tun, was dein Oh.
den Sieg und zu tun, was deinem Herzen entspricht. Du bist der Hörer des Gebets, ich komm zu dir, wenn du ein Wort in deiner Form hast und es geschieht. Du bist der Hörer des Gebets, dein Geist ist hier, um zu tun, was deinem Herzen entspricht.
Let's take time to pray for our leaders. Er ist der Hörer, der hier ist. God who answered prayer. Lift up your voice, lift up your hands, lift your heart. Let's pray. Lift up your voice, lift up your heart and pray. When God speaks, the walls are coming down. There's nothing worth more that will ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living hope. Your presence, Lord. I've tasted and seen sweetest of love, where my heart becomes free and my
Hashem is alive in your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory.
Für unsere Nationen,
God's heart for our nations,
für unser Vaterland,
for our home country.
Gottes Herz zerspringt fast,
God's heart is almost bursting,
voll von Liebe für dich,
full of love for you,
egal ob du alt oder jung bist,
whether you're old or young.
Die besten Tage deines Lebens liegen vor dir.
The best days of your life are still ahead.
Die hast du noch gar nicht erlebt.
You haven't even experienced them yet.
Was kommt, ist viel größer als das, was war.
The things that are coming are much greater than the things that have passed.
Und es geht tiefer.
And it's going deeper.
Und es ist reicher.
And it's richer.
Weil das Vaterherz Gottes durchkommt.
Because the Father heart of God is coming
in unsere Nation.
In our nations.
Und in die Nationen Europas.
And in the nations of Europe.
Und in die Herzen.
And in the hearts.
Der Menschen dieser Welt.
Of the people of this world.
Halleluja. Danke, Vater.
Thank you, Father.
Vater, so danke ich dir für das, was wir jetzt hier erlebt haben miteinander.
Father, I thank you for what we've experienced here together.
Für das Miteinander der Generationen.
For the generations joining together.
Dass wir einander ehren und lieben.
That we honor and love each other.
Einander unterstützen und tragen.
And that we support and carry each other.
Und Seite an Seite.
Side by side.
Dein Reich bauen.
To build your kingdom together.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Vielen Dank.
Amen. Thank you very much.
Amen. Amen.
Welcome back, guys. That was just a wonderful time there of just honoring the people who have gone before and then commissioning the next generation. And that wasn't just for Todd and Ben. And that just wasn't just for the leaders on the stage. It's symbolic. It's showing that, look, we're standing in for the young generation. That's us. That's what God wants to do, the next thing. And we want to honor and respect those who have gone before us. Do you want to talk a little bit about culture of honor?
Yeah, absolutely. No, I just was thinking about that. The Lord just reminded me of the scripture about Jesus and his attitude towards us. It says in the book of Philippians, it says this, don't be selfish. Don't try to impress others. Be humble. thinking of others as better than yourselves. Some translation says, esteem others as better than yourselves. Don't look out only for your own interests, but take an interest in others too. You must have the same attitude that Christ Jesus had. Think about this. This is Jesus. Jesus isn't selfish. He doesn't, when he was on the earth, he wasn't here to try and impress other people. He was very much not like that at all. He was humble and he thought of other people better than himself. This is the God that we serve. And then it says, though he was God, he did not think of equality with God as something to cling to. Instead, he gave up his divine privileges. He took the humble position of a slave and was born as a human being. When he appeared in human form, he humbled himself in obedience to God and died a criminal's death on the cross. And so God honored him above everybody else. So this is the thing. God honors people. Jesus honors people. And in the kingdom of heaven, everyone is valuable and everyone is worth it. And Jesus, as our King, doesn't overlord it on people, but in fact is lower than everyone and serves people because he believes that they are better than himself. That's amazing. So on the stage, we honor those that have gone before us as better than ourselves, and the older generation are honoring the younger as better than themselves because Jesus Christ lives inside of them. And when you are honoring the person that God lives inside, you're honoring him. So, and Jesus says this, he says, if you treat a prophet or a righteous person or even one of these little ones, just giving them a cup of water, you are honoring me and you are honoring the Father. So the superstar, the person who's on your level and the person who we think is not as spiritual as us, if you honor them, you're honoring Jesus and Jesus honors you. So we just think that people are so valuable that we want to love them and serve them and make them feel like kings. And that's an amazing honor that we get to do that. So it was a really precious moment and very sweet that these two people would do that to the older generation that wanted to bless them.
And I think something that's striking me as we've been here at this conference is what we're hearing again and again is that it's not you give a little bit, you get a little bit. It's not even actually yesterday. Daniel Kalenda shook me a little bit because I'd never thought of this. I think it was Daniel. Oh, no, it was Todd who said, it's not about I must decrease so he can increase. It's about I must die so that he can live in me. It's not about I'm going to give a little bit. It's about giving freely because you receive freely. It's about giving everything. It's not about honoring some and honoring a little bit and honoring here. It's not about incorporating Jesus into your life. It's about pouring your life out for Jesus. And so the Lord's really striking my heart because it's a theme that's coming up again and again. Because I think for so long in the church, we've considered, oh, okay, well, I'll bring Jesus into my life. No, I will give my life for Jesus and I will lay down my life for love. And that's something that's being said again and again. This afternoon, we want to continue to lay down our lives in love. We actually have not so much a commissioning service, but a teaching and equipping service, which will be in like an hour. We want you guys to join us because you at home have the unique privilege of being able to participate, to receive, and then to go out and give.
That's right. Jesus had the ministry, it says in the first chapter of the book of Acts. He had a ministry of teaching and doing. So not only do we teach people, we want you to actually put it into practice. Faith works when you actually do it. Faith works with action. So we want you to be involved. Please join us. It's going to be in a couple of hours. And Todd and Ben...
Is it in one hour? So break for lunch. We're going to break for lunch. We want you to be back here joining us. Have your coat on. Be ready to go out and preach the gospel of Jesus Christ to the nations. We love you guys and we'll see you later.
We need prophets of the living God who know their God.